Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. You may be seated. Good afternoon. Welcome to Convocation 2021. We begin today's ceremonies by acknowledging that the land on which Champlain College St. Lambert resides is located on unceded Indigenous lands. The Kayenken Haka Nation is recognized as the custodians of the lands and waters on which we gather today. We ask that settlers on this territory keep these living histories in mind with heightened awareness to the context faced by Indigenous peoples as we move forward together. Once again, good afternoon. My name is Anthony Singlis. I am the Dean in charge of academics, which means that the majority of students present this afternoon have never met me before, which is a good thing, because you generally see me only when you are in trouble. So congratulations, you're meeting me for the first time. I am very pleased on behalf of Champlain St. Lambert, its governing boards, faculty, administration, and staff, and Odette Côté, our Director General. I am delighted to welcome you to Champlain St. Lambert's commencement ceremonies for the class of 2021. In this, our fourth presentation of the day, we will be celebrating the efforts of students in psychology and commerce options of social science, as well as the students in the media programs. Today's joyful event honors all 2021 graduates for successfully completing the requirements for their chosen studies. Once again, congratulations to all. Before we begin, I have been tasked with some housekeeping reminders. First, cell phones are to be turned off or switched to the silent operating mode during the ceremony. Graduates in particular, we ask that you do not text during the ceremony. As a courtesy to and out of respect for your fellow graduates, you and your family are requested to remain under the tent until the conclusion of the ceremony. And finally, a gentle reminder, Champlain St. Lambert is a smoke-free college, including all grounds of the campus, so smoking is not permitted anywhere on the grounds. To start our ceremony this afternoon, I call to the stage Dr. Odette Côté, the college's Director General.
Thank you, Anthony. Good afternoon, everyone. Mr. François Paradis, Chairman of the Board of Governors, Mrs. Dawn Smith, who is the Chairperson of the Governing Board, but who could not be here with us today, Board and Governing Board members, Mr. Don Schuwen, sitting right here, Constituent College Director, distinguished guests, colleagues, graduates, Champlain employees, ladies and gentlemen. We wish to thank you for being here today to celebrate the success of our students. Parents and friends, we share the same pride to see that our graduates are ready to undertake new challenges, different paths to attain new summits. Their successes are the result of the unconditional support, the comprehension, and the generosity that they receive during their studies, and that they received from all of you, the people in the back, the people in the platform party, and all the employees of the college. Research does say that for every person that succeeds, a student, there's usually around 30 people around that makes this possible. So thanks to all those who have supported their efforts and have contributed to their success during this unprecedented pandemic, where you all found innovative ways in helping them to get to the finish line. Dear students, speaking of the pandemic, nothing prepared any of us for this. Neither are we ever prepared enough for life's challenges. But uncertainties do allow us to keep our balance, to stay agile, and to expect the unexpected. We must learn to accept failure and work hard to succeed in doing what we love. Graduation is just the beginning of a long journey where the field of intervention now covers the entire planet. The challenges are enormous, and you will have the opportunity, even the duty, to contribute to solutions. It is with skills, innovation, and grit that you will dare intervene in changing the world while supporting the values of new generations. Strive for excellence, just like you did to get here today, where the extra efforts will bring you pride in the expected results, elevating you to other summits. The diploma that you receive crowns the incommensurate academic and collective talents and efforts that you have deployed through a host of extremely intelligent and exceptionally talented people. Do not ever be afraid to take the necessary steps to pursue your dreams. A success lies between obstacles, passion, and perseverance. Never give up. I want to maybe highlight anyone who's been watching tennis lately. We have a young Quebecer, 19 years old. Her name is Leila Fernandez, hardly known to the tennis world. She's been just going up and up and up and has been winning against top tennis people of the world. So take with you the lessons learned at Champlain to live a good life full of freshness, humor, and insight. Choose to be a wonderful human being and take care of what really matters to you. We wish you the very best, and you will always be welcome at Champlain. Sincere congratulations.
Thank you, Odette. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome our graduates to the stage. And to help me with the presentation, I ask Andrea Vitatek to come up. Our first graduates will be from the psychology option of the social science program. And our first graduate is Ashley Alarcon Astudillo. Lea Bayalargio. Bianca Balash. Coali Bison. Maria José Camargo Casedo. Jessica Chen. Sarah Desev. Laura Durocher. Sarah Giraldo. Clara Laflamme. And to continue with the presentation, I ask that Jean-François Mazelin and Rachel Morris also come to the stage. Frédéric Martin. Lauriane Richard. Zachary Roy. Maïka Saint-Cyr. And we have one more graduate from psychology, Felicia Trohan. Jean-François, Rachel, and Andrea, thank you for the time being. We now continue with the commerce option. And for the commerce option, we ask Christine Hayes to come to the stage. Our first graduate in commerce is Anne Elizabeth Blow. Laurie Chandonnet. Isabelle Chicarins. Marie-Lie Chionis. Michael Smaglia. Sophia Carolina Delphin Gonzalez. Christopher Graham. Ramas Hinnan. Omed Hosseini. Justine Lambert. Carmen Liang. Thank you, Christine. I ask Jean-François Meslin to come back up to the stage to continue the presentation for Commerce. Our next graduate, Alexandra Nitu. Brandano Petroza. Bianca Poirier. And one more graduate from Commerce, Amélie Tougas-Tremblay. Thank you, Jean-François. We now continue with Arts, Literature, and Communication, Language, and Culture. And I call to the stage Gilles Verchil. Our first graduate, Audrey Brassard. Léla Desjardins. Zoé Languille. Chloé Larose. Chloé is also the recipient of the Language and Culture Prize. Alessandra Cristiana Popescu. Marc-Antoine Provencher. And our final graduate from Language and Culture is Audrey Thunblum. Thank you, Gervasio. We continue with digital arts and new media. I call Pascal Nguyen to the stage. And our first graduate is Megan Alien Brasio. Florence Charbonneau. Maude Garneau. Maude has also earned the Media Certificate of Merit in Digital Arts and New Media. Renaud Alexis Klimov. Nicholas Leduc. Maja Lukonen. Juliana Ocho Fernandez. Abigail O'Toole. Lorianne Patti. And one more graduate from Digital Arts and New Media, Olenka Uwen. Pascal, thank you. To continue, we are now with film and new media, and I call Nancy Tatabe to the stage. Our first graduate, Apollon Barreros. Nicole Benjarano Libreros. Cameron Brodeur. Rosemary Caron. Maxime Cloutier. Nina Desrosiers. Camille Devroid. Malay Fraser. Noemi Lugo. Diana Lopez Corrales. Florence Rossico-Mangui. Leticia Roberta de Belfelli. Theodore Simeon. Ladies and gentlemen, not only our final graduate in film and new media, and our final graduate in the digital program, and our final graduate of the afternoon, but our final graduate for the class of 2021 is Daphne Vaillancourt. Nancy, thank you. I give you the graduates from social science, psychology, social science, commerce, our language and culture program, and our media programs. Congratulations to all the graduates. And without further ado, I welcome to the stage the director of our college, Champlain St. Lambert. He's also the director of studies, Mr. Don Schuin.
Quite a bunch. Let me just do one thing before I forget, because I promised Sheila I would do this, and the first time I screwed it up, and so that's kind of embarrassing. She asked me to ask you not to forget to pick up your souvenir gifts and get your official Champlain graduation photo taken courtesy of the Champlain Student Association. And they were in a tent in the back, but I can't see them now. They're around the front, but they still have the stuff for you. Now, before I get started, Anthony and I, few of the administrators, have this thing where we talk about who the noisiest group is. We were pretty near prepared to award it to one of the gang here today, but I think we have a problem because you folks sent in a spy. There's somebody who's been here since 9 o'clock this morning. He's a Champlain graduate. He's been working the whole day. Apollon Barrières, would you just wave to the people, please? There he is. Yeah. So, you can now figure out who won the prize for the noisiest students for our friends in digital arts and new media, particularly the film and new media people, but we'll put y'all together. Yeah, I know it. Okay. And I'll have to tell the nursing students to keep practicing for next year. The last time I do this for this year, you know, it's been a tough time. Let's be honest. The last 2 years haven't been easy, last year and a half, and more for you than any of us in many ways. Distancing, confinement, isolation. And then we come here today and we hear the cheering and the enthusiasm. What's really nice is when you do it for each other. That's quite amazing when you think about it. That kind of affection is, it's absolutely wonderful, but today we really do have something worth celebrating, your graduation. And after all the work and the study and the reading and exams, assignments, pressure, shifting to remote learning, worry, late-nighters, all-weekers, bad coffee and cold pizza, you really do deserve the diplomas that you got. You really do.
J'aimerais profiter de l'occasion pour remercier les étudiants qui ont choisi de poursuivre leurs études en anglais au Collège Champlain. Nous apprécions la confiance que vous nous avez accordée. Étudier dans une langue seconde demande la motivation, la persévérance et la patience. La fierté de votre réussite nous touche chacun et chacune.
On est à un point dans notre société où on espère pouvoir accueillir autant d'étudiants francophones dans les années à venir parce que pour nous, c'est une richesse. C'est une richesse parce qu'à Champlain, on a le privilège de vivre ensemble, de mieux s'apprendre l'un et l'autre, puis de bâtir une future pour le Québec ensemble dont on va être tous fiers et tout heureux de partager. Fait que j'espère que nous puissions le faire dans les années à venir.
Nice, you clap for me as much as you do for your fellow students. Thank you. Now, before I go on, there's a couple of things that I want to do, and I'm going to flip the order. Sitting at the back of the tent, there's a whole bunch of people who don't have on blue caps and gowns. Their parents, their brothers and sisters, their loved ones, they're people who through thick and thin, stood by you. And on behalf of the college, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for the privilege of having the ones you love come here. I want to thank you for everything you've done for them, because without that, we wouldn't have a bunch of them here today. You made a difference, you make a difference, and we are so very grateful to you for what you do. So, join me, if you would, in a round of applause for all of them, okay? And now, I want to talk about the people who make Champlain what it is, our faculty and our staff. I've said it, you guys didn't get, well, Christine got to hear, but nobody else did. The faculty don't come here to work for a paycheck. They need it, but that's not why they come here. Faculty don't put in extra hours on nights and weekends and outside of their supposed hour or time of availability, because they have to. Faculty don't bust their necks figuring out how to deliver teaching in a whole different way, except because the thing they care about the most is you and your learning. That's incredible. That's who these people are. They're the bedrock of what we build upon. And I don't want to forget the staff, because nothing any of us do without support and professionals and a whole bunch of other people. It wouldn't work. And to all of these people, here's what I want you to do. If you're sitting there in a blue cap and gown, please stand up. This is not a phys ed credit, okay? I want us to give them a standing ovation for what they've done during your time here.
And now you can all have a seat. Thank you.
You know, more than anything else I said, the enthusiasm of their reaction speaks volumes about who you are and what you do. And they and I thank you. It really is important. Now, I come to you this afternoon as somebody whose generation's time is rapidly passing. I know, it makes me sound like I'm about to go to the old age home. But I also come to you as somebody who has no right to call you to action, to ask you to pick up the burden, one that my generation, oh my golly, we sure can't brag about how we handled it. But yet, I must. I must for the sake of my children and my grandchildren and someday yours. Because if we don't get you to pick up the challenges that are ahead of us, we're doomed. Now, we don't need to make a list of the major problems that our world faces. You can name them just as well as I can and probably add a few I've missed. But somehow it seems to me on 9/11 that it's particularly appropriate to consider them as we remember the events of 20 years ago, the part of the world we lived in changed forever. Now, as I was writing this, it struck me that for most of you, you were what? Somewhere between 0 and 3 years old when this happened. So the world you've lived in has always been what it is. But I can tell you that an almost naive sense of security, safety, and dare I say, invulnerability was lost in the society around us. And now I need to make one more observation that concerns me. I don't know about you, but it seems to me that the level of intolerance, you know, I'd even go far as to say hatred in some cases, that folks keep seeming to increasingly have for people who don't share the same vision or opinions that they do, is growing. It's on the rise. Now, as I started to think about that, the first thought I had, of course, was our neighbors to the south. Thank goodness. You know, it's largely them and the problems that they have, and you know, we can look at their elections and we can look at, you know, their problems of equity and diversity, and then we stop and we look at the things that have happened to us of late. And we look at residential schools and we look at the behavior that we see now in Canadian elections. My gosh, they look like the same thing just happened in the States, where people stand there and don't give people a chance to talk. They scream them down. We can look at the people who don't think you should have to have a vaccination or wear a mask. Now, their opinion is legitimate. But what's not legitimate is that they bully those who believe that it's the right thing to do. And yet that keeps growing in our country. And I am concerned that we're allowing intolerance and incivility to fester. And there's only one outcome that inevitably occurs when we do that. Somewhere in our society it turns to violence, and none of us want that. It's not the place we should have to live. So I recognize, though, that for a bunch of you, this is just going to be another speech, something that you endured sitting there in less than comfortable chairs, and this will soon be forgotten. No one should miraculously expect that all of you sitting out there are going to jump up and tackle one problem or another that's facing this world. That would be too much to expect and too much to ask. But my job is to plant seeds and hope that in each group, and that includes the one that's here right now, that in each group there may be one or two or a handful of you who will decide that they can make a change. They can make a difference, may not change the world, but they can sure change the life in a few others. Never mind, you can change the life in a few others. And hopefully, when you do that, you're going to inspire them to do the same thing. And then we're going to get some kind of a multiplication. Now, pick the issue that's nearest to your heart. Well, pick something that's my priority. Pick the one that you care about the most. And do something. Take a small step. And then another. And then pass this feeling on to the people that you've reached out to. So that if each one of us helps one other person, they help another person, this thing's going to multiply, and sooner or later we can do something about the problems that we face, not by saying we can't, but by saying we have. Now I dare to ask you, because of what you've accomplished during your stay at Champlain and who you are, you have demonstrated a capacity for critical thinking. You can figure things out and make informed judgments. You don't need other people to do that for you. You have demonstrated a high degree of intelligence, and if I didn't believe that, there's no way I'd sign every one of those diplomas that you got sitting in your laps. And I did, and I was proud of it, because you are intelligent. And more than any class, you have demonstrated a resilience that is remarkable. In midstream, you had to switch from the type of learning that's been our tradition at Champlain for nearly 50 years and jump into something completely new and yet untried, at least at Champlain on this scale, and you didn't drop by the wayside. You didn't throw up your hands and say, this is too hard, I give up. You ran the race and you crossed the finish line a winner. That's why I can say it. And this tells me you have the capacity to achieve so much, pretty much everything you set your mind to. So I ask you this, are you willing to take that talent, that intelligence, that resilience, and use it to make a difference in this world? I want to close with a story. There's a well-known author who used to go to the ocean every morning to do his writing. Now, he had a habit of walking along the beach before he began. And one morning, as he was walking along the shore, he looked down the beach, and he saw someone moving like a dancer. Now, you guys who are in the arts will laugh at me if I tried, but moving like a dancer. And he smiled to himself, and he thought at the thought of somebody who'd like to start their day in the joy of a dance. And so he walked faster to catch up. And as he got closer, he noticed that it was the figure of a young man, and that what he was doing wasn't dancing at all. The young man was reaching down and picking up some small objects and throwing them into the ocean. And he came closer still, and he called out, good morning. Can I ask you what you're doing? And the young man stopped. And he looked at the old fellow and he said, I'm throwing starfish into the ocean. So the look he got back was, am I going to ask, why on earth are you doing that? Why are you throwing starfish? And to this the young man replied, the sun is up. The tide is going out. Oh, wait, because I don't want to compete. And so he said, if I don't throw them in, they'll die. On hearing this, the writer said, but young man, don't you realize that there are miles and miles and miles of beach and there are starfish along every mile? You can't possibly make a difference. And at this, the young man bent down and he picked up another starfish and threw it into the ocean. And as it met the water, he looked at the man and he said, it made a difference to that one. It made a difference to that one. We don't have to be rich. We don't have to be the most talented in the world. We don't have to be the smartest one on the block to make the difference in the life of another. We just need to remember that we're here for a purpose, and that making small changes in this world eventually add up to something bigger in the life of another. So, as I finish this talk, my final question to each of you is this. What difference do you want to make? Thank you for making Champlain a better place. You've made a difference already because you came here and you brought something to this place we wouldn't have without you. Thank you. We're proud to have had you. We're grateful to have had you. Congratulations. And from me and from everybody here, please accept our best wishes for a life that's full of joy and good health. Congratulations, graduates. The last piece that we have is the presentation of the number of awards. Before I do that, there was something that struck me when Odette was up talking before. François Paradis is the chairman of the Board of Governors of Champlain Regional College. Now you can always say, oh, that's really nice, but here's the thing. He is a graduate of Champlain. Twice, in fact, he came back and did a second diploma. The chairman, and it's because Odette mentioned Don Smith, the chairman of our local governing board is a graduate of this college and came back and decided to do something. And we're thrilled that she's the chair. By the way, she was in the first group of graduates ever at Champlain. The president of our foundation is, oh, wait for it, a graduate of Champlain. The reason I'm telling you that is that there is place for you in all of those things. And if it wasn't for people like Francois and Don and Mike Newton, we couldn't do the things we do. So I'd like to now invite Zaki Benner up to present the Dean Cheshire Memorial Award.
Hello. I shouldn't have started with them. The Dean Cheshire Memorial Award is named in honor of the first coordinator of the digital arts program at Champlain. It's given to a student for excellence in studio art. This year, the award goes to Florence Charbonneau.
So now, the next award is the Potter Family Award. And I am grateful to Dean Howie for letting me have the privilege of presenting this. The Potter family has a relationship with Champlain that dates back to the 1970s. Arthur, who unfortunately passed away, was the first director of studies of the regional college. He was, before that, a teacher in philosophy and humanities at a St. Lawrence campus in Quebec City. Alex Potter, oh, about 25, 30 years ago, had, where is he, hiding behind me, Anthony's job. But he was the dean here, and the other thing is he was a good friend. So getting a chance, he's not well. So keep him in your thoughts and prayers if you would. These are people who cared about Champlain and cared about you students. And so their award cycles across our three constituent colleges over 3 years. It's given to a student who submitted a text that demonstrates critical thinking, a passion for learning, and a desire to make a change in the world. And this year, the award is given to Léa Bayargent. And that just about brings us to the end of our ceremony. Guess you guys could say we saved the best for last, right? I would like to have a chance to thank a few people before you leave. Anthony reminded you, if you folks could hang on in here for a little bit, those of us over here will get out of your way so that graduates and family can all get together, take photos. As long as you're the same family, I guess you can even exchange hugs. Just don't tell us, because we don't want to get in trouble with this use. And so there we are. An event like this doesn't happen by accident. There are just so many people who deserve thanks and praise. And in the end, it's always a team effort. First, you see them out front. Go get your t-shirt. Well, you see one on the camera. To our student volunteers, if you were looking for a face for this college, it wouldn't be me. It wouldn't be any of us who work here. It would be our students, because our students are such amazing, amazing ambassadors for this place that I'll put them up and in front and stand my reputation on who you are any day. And at the end, I'll come out looking smarter than I am. That's how good you guys are. But to the ones who worked here today to make it a success, thank you. Pat, thank you again. As my voice runs out by the end of the day, he manages to make it sound like it's still working. To the folks who are doing the filming, there are people who couldn't be here today, partly because we only have so much room, partly because there were health things that prevented them, and it's on YouTube. Thanks to the people who are doing that, folks who didn't get to participate live still get to see you, still get to live the experience, and that's because people have done this, and that's incredible. Don't want to forget the people in buildings and equipment, because as you walk around the place, I've heard a lot of parents say it looks like a private school. My answer is there's only two differences. One, we look better, and two, you don't have to pay tuition. But that's the people who manage that part of the thing. And last, but certainly not least, I want to thank the people in student services, Sheila and Vince and Scott. And the guy who's standing at the back, he's going to yell at me afterwards, and I don't care. If I owe a debt to one person for this thing today, it's Dean Howie. And you ought to know it. And he can be as mad as he wants, but I got to tell you. He has done an unbelievable job. He's managing this and our COVID response at the same time. And thank God we have him. So the whole team in student services, he'd be the first one to tell you it's his group that make it possible. Thank you. And so, as I said, just hang on a wee bit and we'll get out of your road. But there's one last thing to do. In a graduation, as I understand it, and I'm sure you do, the graduates get to stand up and throw their hat up in the air. So here's what we're going to do. If you want to first stand up, we'll count down from three, because at this time of the day, that's about as much as I can handle. And then you get to throw your hats. And if somebody wants to throw one, this dear lady in crutches, please pick up her hat for her, would you? Thank you. So here we go. 3, 2, 1. Congratulations, graduates.